Introduction to the Oscilloscope, Part A. The function generator will be used to create the signal, and the oscilloscope will be used to measure the signal. We will be connecting the devices with a BNC cable, also known as a coaxial cable. Connect one end of the cable to the function generator. Be sure to push it in and turn it till it clicks into place. A bad connection can lead to a bad signal. Connect the other end to the output on the function generator. Turn the oscilloscope on the switch. Turn the function generator on with the button. There are three red knobs on top of three green knobs. Turn the red knob and just the red knob all the way clockwise until it clicks. If you don't do this, none of your measurements will be correct. If you don't have a signal or you have a poor signal, look for the trigger source switch and push it all the way up to INT, which stands for internal. Then adjust the trigger level knob until you get a clear signal. If you still don't have a clear signal, call your instructor over. There are four buttons on the function generator down here. For anything we're doing, they should just be in the off position. Off is out. These three buttons control the type of waveform that is being output. The first one outputs a sine wave, or what's called AC current. The second one is called a square wave, which we will use to mimic an open and close switch in the RL and RC circuit labs. The last one is a sawtooth wave, which we won't be using in our labs. This row of buttons at the top is what we use to select the range of frequencies that we want to work in. We're going to start with 500 Hz. Then we're going to use these knobs to adjust the exact output frequency that we want. You can adjust the output voltage with this knob on the function generator. Once you have set frequency and voltage for the function generator, don't change it, because we're learning how to measure a signal and it wouldn't make sense to change it in the middle of measurement. The green knob is the voltage scale knob. It's marked off in units of voltage per division. Adjusting the volts per division knob to a higher setting causes the signal to be smaller on the screen, and to a lower setting causes the signal to be bigger on the screen. This knob is the sweep time adjust knob. It's marked off in units of time per division. Adjusting the knob to a higher setting gives you more displayed cycles, and adjusting to a lower gives you fewer. The oscilloscope is like a graph. The vertical axis is the voltage, and the horizontal axis is the time. The following is the coupling switch. Most of the time, you put it on DC, even if you're recording an AC signal. If we switch it on ground, then we can find out where the zero for voltage is. When we switch the coupling switch to ground, we need to switch the trigger source to line, or it won't draw the signal. Switching to ground, switching source to line. This is the ground adjust knob, or the voltage position. It decides at what vertical level the ground will be displayed. We generally adjust the ground level to some line on the oscilloscope that's convenient to measure from. After we've adjusted the ground, we put our coupling back on DC. The trigger source is still online and the signal's unstable. We need to trigger internally, so I push it to internal. The peak-to-peak voltage is measured from the bottom of the signal to the top of the signal. I count the number of divisions, or boxes, from the bottom to the top, and then I'll multiply that number times the volts per division that the dial is set on. There'll be a little white line lined up with some number on one side or the other. We want to adjust the time sweep knob until we have basically one wave displayed. We might want to do a ground level adjustment to make sure that the ground is on some convenient line for measuring from. Then I can put it back on DC, back on internal, and if I need to, adjust the trigger. The trigger level tells it at what voltage to start drawing the picture, and I can adjust the trigger level to some convenient spot. If I adjust the trigger outside the range of voltages of the signal disappears. The signal is stretched as far as it can in time while still having one full wave displayed. Then I count the number of boxes for one full wave. I'm counting from where the signal crosses the zero on the way up to the next place the signal crosses the zero on the way up. And then I multiply times the time per division on this dial. Now I have the period of the wave. 1 over the period is the frequency, and that value should match the number on the function generator.